हेलो गाइस एंड वेलकम टू आवर प्ले लिस्ट ऑफ असेंबली लैंग्वेज प्रोग्रामिंग इन 8085 माइक्रो प्रोसेसर। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी द 8085 प्रोग्राम टू फाइंड द टोटल नंबर ऑफ ऑड एंड इवन नंबर्स थ्रू अ डेटा एरे। सो आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड हाउ टू फाइंड वेदर द नंबर इज ऑड और इवन, एंड इफ यू डोंट नो अबाउट दैट देन प्लीज वॉच आउट दैट वीडियो एंड यू कैन गेट द लिंक इन द आई बटन। That video will help you to understand about this video very well. Because see, if you don't know how to check whether a number is odd or even, then it will not be possible to find the total number of odd and even numbers through an array. So as we have done in the previous video, there we had inputted only a single data and we have checked whether this is odd or even, right? But here we need to use the concept of array. So how we used to do the checking of odd or even numbers in that video? Let's consider an example, B3 hex. Okay, so first we had converted it into the binary format. So this is equals to 10110011. Right, now we had focused into the least significant bit of this number. So if the least significant bit is 1, it means this is an odd number. But if this is equals to 0, then it is an even number. Right. Because in decimal also we know that the number ending with 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 are the even numbers. But in binary format, if the least significant bit is 0, then it is an even number. And if it is 1, then it is an odd number. Right. So here we will be checking this condition on an array of numbers. So let's say we are having 6 number of elements. So we will store the total number of elements in the array in the register C. Okay. And then we will input all the elements in that array. So let's say there are 6 elements and the elements are A0 hex, B3, 52, 7E, 01 and C2. Okay, these are the elements. Now we will access all the elements one by one and we will check whether this is odd or even. And how we will store the count of odd and even numbers, we will use two registers for that. So let's say we will use register B and the register D. If the number is even, then it will be stored in the B register. And if it is an odd number, then it will be stored in the D register. Okay. So in this example, you can see that A0 is even number, B3 is odd, 52 is even, 7E is even, 01 is odd, and C2 is also even. So the even numbers are 4, so B will be storing 4, and there are 2 odd numbers, so it will be stored in the register D. Right, so in this way we will do the operations. Now let's write its assembly language program. So I am starting the input from C050 hex address. So first we will input the total number of elements. So it will be inputted from C050 hex address. So in the beginning we will use LXI H, C050 hex to input the total number of elements and it will be moved into the register C. Now we will start inputting all the elements one by one. But before doing that, I want to initialize the register B and D with 00 hex so that they does not contain any garbage values. So MVI B, 00 hex. This will initialize the B register with 00 and D register with 00. Now to input the first data, we will use INXH. So A will be inputted from C051 hex address. Now we will move this content into the accumulator. So how we will check whether its least significant bit is 1 or 0? We will use a rotate write instruction. Right, we have already discussed it in that video. So RAR instruction, that is rotate accumulator towards right. Now after rotating this content towards right, if the LSB contains 1, then the carry flag will be containing 1. And if it will be 0, then the carry flag will also contain 0. So here we will check the content of the carry flag to know whether it is an odd or even number. So we will use a jump if carry loop. Now if you are having any confusion in understanding why we are doing these things, then please watch out that previous video of odd and even number checking. Now, when we will see the content of the carry flag, that means if a carry flag contains 1, then it will jump to a specific line number, okay? But if it contains 0, then what we need to do? If it contains 0, that means this is an even number. And in that case, we need to increment the content of the B register. That's why I have written INR B here. But if the number is odd, then we will increment the content of D. So here, as we are checking the content of the carry flag, so let's say this will jump to this location, okay? So I will write loop here, and when a carry is generated, that means this is an odd number. So we will increment the content of the D register. Alright, and as we have written the instruction for both incrementation of B and D register, next what we will do? We will decrement the total number of elements in the array. Right, so we will use TCRC. Now we will check whether this is equals to 0 or not. So JNZ loop, oh, this is also a loop, so let's write this is a loop 1, okay, and this is loop 2. So if C is not equals to 0, that means we have not reached the end of the array. So what we need to do, if this is not equals to 0, then we will take another input. So for taking the another input and doing all the operations in the same way, we will go from this location to here. Because see, if this is not equal to 0, then again we will take another input from this location. Then again we will move it into the accumulator, and then the same process will continue. But if this is equal to 0, it means what? It means that we have reached to the end of the array and we do not want to input another element any further. So this is the loop part. But one thing is wrong here, because see, whenever a number is even, then we will increment the B register, but after execution of this line, the control will go to the next line, so it will also increment the content of the D register. But we don't want it, right? Because if a number is even, then we only need to increment the content of B and not the content of D. So how we can avoid the execution of this instruction? Here we will use a JMP loop. Okay, this is unconditional jump. So let's say this is loop 3. So ignoring this line, where we will go? We will go to this location. So this loop 3 will go to this location. Alright. And then we will decrement the content of C. Then again we will check whether this is 0 or not, and the same process will continue. So in this way we will check all the numbers whether they are odd or even. So what we need to store as a result? The content of B and D register, right? So I'm writing here, for storing the content of B, first we need to move it into the accumulator, right? So A comma B, and we will store it in some location, let's say C100 hex address. Alright. And now we need to store the content of D also. So we will also move it into the accumulator, and we will store the content of D in C101 hex address. And then halt. Okay. So in this way this program works. Here see, we are using 3 loops. So don't confuse with these loops. Just you need to remember where the control of these loop are going, right? Loop 3 is here and loop 2 is here. So I hope this program is clear to you. Now, just modifying a single instruction in this program, we can check the total number of positive and negative number in an array. How? Here, in place of RAR, just use RAL instruction. Because see, whenever a number is positive or negative, we used to check the most significant bit of that number. If this is 1, then it is a negative number. But if it is a 0, then it is a positive number. So by rotating it towards left, we can check this content, and the same process will work. So just try it, replace RAR with RAL instruction, and the program will work for counting the total number of positive and negative number. But there is another method through which we can count the total number of positive and negative numbers in an array, and that method is much precise and easier than this process. I'll discuss it in the next video. So, and you can also watch out the other videos regarding 8085 macroprocessor in this playlist. So see you in the next video. Thank you.